Us too, they generally tend to do better on Inferno if you like the what we call in the UK the mixing maps, the maps that you can just throw a bunch of players together and rely on for a bit of aim and that kind of thing. So we will see how they do. VERYGAMES dropping down onto that pallet so you don't take damage and setting up on this lower site just to shut down any early rushes. So ANEXIS have kind of been pushed into slow thing. Looks like they're going to work the outside area. You can see Kenny S is taking a bit of flak up in Crow's Nest. So although Glaive has as well, and he's got the full complement of nades still. So it's actually quite a slow round, but ANEXIS are now committing to outside. And Scream in ramp room, not got a lot to do, so he's going to feel comfortable pushing through. You see, since he's going to flash up, going to push into the lobby, going to get one. That's great from him. Read the situation very well and timed that to perfection. In the meantime, Scream, of course, has pushed through radio room, so he's having a look around and he's going to basically tell everyone on his team that reconnaissance wise, it's clear there, so they can push through. ANEXIS, though, have managed to get below Crows. They'll probably hear them going because those jumps aren't silent. And ANEXIS, Glaive just pushing through there to get that kill. So 4v4 situation, MSL having a little spam on someone who managed, some VERYGAMES who managed to get onto the roof. And MSL might be able to get into this hut area. Oh dear, that doesn't sound good. That's a grenade landing right at his feet, so that's going to get the kill. And Nico's kind of moving around, but in the meantime, VERYGAMES are going to shut this down. Nico, last man standing, and Existence had a great round there, picked up two very important kills. Kenny S mopping up the gravy, so to speak, at the end.
Yeah, great round from VERYGAMES right there. The key to that round was when they pushed lobby, I would say. And that just shows the difference from when you call information. I see many teams just call out, if they would see two smokes yard and the guys running down the stairs, they would just call out, oh, they're coming yard, they're coming yard. But I actually think they're like, okay, there's three guys at yard. I spotted three guys. Then we can push lobby because we know there's a maximum of two persons in the lobby. It's easy math, basically.
Well, yeah, and it's not just about that. It's about sort of painting a picture of the map, relaying the information to everyone, spread out to your teammates, and basically enabling them to get into better positions. If you kind of think about it like, I use another sporting metaphor, a full court press, what you do is you push yourself into positions where you can defend higher up from the choke points, give yourself that advantage to have quicker rotates. So I should probably stay with the eco rounds actually in this game, because we've already seen a couple of great ones, and ANEXIS have played themselves into a brilliant position. Smith spamming away his teammate in the back there, but worked in his favour somehow, managed to pick up two kills, but Pimp has answered back, Scream the last man standing. This is a 1v2 situation. ANEXIS might be able to just do an eco round here. The bomb has been planted in that lower area, so Glaive's holding upper in hut. Scream, though, is already going to be down there. You can see he's getting awfully close to Pimp. He's going to come through the window. Pimp is going to call it, and he's going to do it with a headshot. So an eco round straight away from ANEXIS against a VERYGAMES CT on their map to make it 1-1.
Yeah. We have to apologize for not watching that eco, but seriously, winning a Glock eco. Okay, they had like two P250s, but an eco nonetheless as T on this map against VERYGAMES. It's like maybe they have lost like four of them in official tournaments now. Less like that might be their first one in official tournaments, I would say.
Just incredible play from ANEXIS, and it's really put the ball in their court now as a terrorist. And again, I cannot stress this enough, VERYGAMES are absolutely phenomenal on this map. They've now been forced into a CT eco in the second round. We can see from the map it doesn't look like they're going to stack anywhere, so they're not panicking. But again, that super aggressive play from ANEXIS really paying dividends. And now they're able to get the guns. They're going to spam away through the smoke. They're going to force, I think it's a Scream, to drop to lower on the ramp. And now Pimp is going to peek and flash through Squeaky. Another flash coming in. They're able to get out on Squeaky. That's one kill going to go the way of Smith. Pimp's going to answer back. Kenny S is going to get another kill. And Smith has dropped down behind him. He's going to get one. It was like Batman swooping down. He's managed to get another one, Existence. And all of a sudden, it's looking like we're about to see another eco. It's a 1v3 situation now. And there's guns galore. And options here. Options for VERYGAMES. Just having a look on the overlay to try and find out where the bomb is.
Clearly, it's not impossible. I mean, they don't have armor.
Oh, but he's getting spammed away through the hut. Nilla needs to peek and get someone quick. And in the end, spammed down through the hut by that Famous. VERYGAMES go 2-for-1. Eco for eco. Mano e mano.
And I have to say, I think this is because of all the pressure. I mean, these are two teams that, I promise you, on practice, they never lose an eco. Mm. And now they both lose an eco two straight in a row. And it just shows that they're nervous, they're making bad decisions. And And this is quite normal for in such a enough semi-final in a prestigious tournament like this.
Well, indeed, and you know, we've already talked about the kind of, if you like, the narrative that goes around it. ANEXIS potentially playing for their position within their organization, and you can see they're going for another hyper-aggressive pistol strike here. Nico manages to pick up a couple of kills before it's pretty much shut down. Glaive, the last man standing, another 1v3 situation, and VERYGAMES is just going to go and hunt him down. But in addition to that, of course, VERYGAMES, a little bit of the shine starting to come off the VERYGAMES name. VERYGAMES becoming, you know, that if people feel that the gap isn't closing between NIP and VERYGAMES, that actually the gap is getting bigger,
and
it's going to be another team that's going to come along and dethrone VERYGAMES, and dethrone NIP, and that means VERYGAMES will be dropping into third position, fourth position. So all of these players here have all got their own little things to prove. They've got their things to prove for their organization, things to prove on an individual basis, because we all know Danish lineups are not shy of chopping and changing a roster. So there's huge, huge stories kind of in the background here in this game. But it's been very close, even Steven so far, and VERYGAMES managing to just edge it 3-1, but we've already seen two
ecos. An AWP for Nico and 4 P250s. This is very, very, very odd from ANEXIS.
I don't know if that's a missed buy. I don't know if that's a mistake.
Yeah, I think so. Or maybe for some reason he has a lot of more money than it's...
And he's resumed dueling there with Kenny S and lost again. So I think that makes it about, what, 3-2 now to Kenny S based on the individual duels they've been having. So Nico holding his own, but... This idea to buy an AWP, well, Glaive's put it to work there to make it a 4v4, but they really need him to get all the kills here because those P250s, as good as they are as a gun, well, take it back. MSL's going to get one, but this is MBK's domain. We've seen him on Nuke so many times playing up, and Glaive's going to take him down, and then he's going to spam it with right, try and take down Smith, but in the end, MBK is just so good at playing behind that those yellow nuclear barrels. That is his position, and he can just peek and kill anyone from there.
And I'm interesting to see if, Nico has an AK, so maybe he just, for some reason, forgot to buy the other rounds or something.
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, I know enough about the player to not rule out that it was a mistake, but equally, it might be a tactic. We've seen that they've got confidence in their aim, and it might have been something they were trying to do aggressive, but at the moment they find themselves 4-1 down, trying to rectify that now on this buy round. 5 AKs for ANEXIS. And obviously, if they do lose this round, money's probably going to be tight. You can see Kenny S is playing in his advanced position from at the top of Crows. He's going to be having a look. He's going to get Nico taken down again. So Nico officially going to be sick of the sight of Kenny S at this stage in the game. And VERYGAMES looking solid at the moment as CT. You can see that ANEXIS now, they've got the reduced numbers, and that doesn't really play into your... it doesn't play to your advantage on you. Nilla tried to get somebody in the smoke. He knew someone there, didn't commit to the spray, and gets taken down by it. So it's now 5v3, and MSL, of course, is very low. Kenny S coming on the rotate. He's going to bang MSL through that smoke. He's going to get pushed again from the other one, and he's just going to pixel peek and get a second kill. So it's all too easy at the moment for VERYGAMES. It's all on pimp as well. We could be looking at a flawless victory, Mortal Kombat style, for VERYGAMES. And ANEXIS have one person left. It is pimp, and as well as he's been playing, 1v5 clutch. You haven't seen one of those these tournaments.
Yeah, either. I think he was going to say it's Gantz is here, 3 grenades as well.
Well, it's the smart thing, but VERYGAMES, of course, have the numbers. They'll probably just want to hunt him down. It's a psychological thing as well as a monetary thing, because when you try and save, if you get killed just before the time runs out,
exactly,
pretty demoralizing.
Yeah, there is always that risk. I mean, many good teams actually just try to spot where the last T is, and then they just wait for the time to run out. So... that's like 2 seconds left now. Hey.
I think he's managed to just evade. Has he? No! Yes! Oh, dear. And in the end, bit of a fail there from MBK. I guess, Kai, you would call it a fail. But it doesn't matter. In the grand scheme of things, VERYGAMES are on 5-1. Let's have a quick look at the frag charge. You can see Smiths is rolling back the years. He's got 9 kills, 4 deaths at the top. Pimp, again, got to be the standout player for ANEXIS, certainly in this game. 5-4 at the top, but never been far from the top of the frag charts. I guess... you can see that it's another eco, so I need to ask you, what are ANEXIS not doing as terrorists to get onto these bomb sites and really shut down VERYGAMES?
Well, it actually has only been one real weapon round so far, because it's been like strange AWP buys, winning ecos, and really back and forth. But the first weapon round, they just decided to go slow, and Kenny S managed to get the entry frag, and that was basically the deciding factor in that round.
Well, we can see that this is going to be a full buy for ANEXIS. Nico's got an AWP. That's going to be integral to any chance they have of being successful. So you can see they're filtering out across the map. We'll have a quick little look here what they're doing. And yeah, the Molotovs have gone down on upper VERYGAMES as well. They were the first real team to kind of look at the merits. Oh, and Pimp gets a headshot through the door there, I think. They were the first team to really look at the merits of using Molotovs, and while other teams were saying, can we just ban them from competitive play, VERYGAMES were sat down and saying, well, how can we make these work? And they still use them as part of when they've got the money and the luxury of doing it. Huge pick from Glaive there on Kenny S. Sorry, on MBK, I should say. MBK was up top in Crows, which is usually Kenny S's lair. Peaked to see if they were outside, and just got his head clean ripped off after doing a little bit of flak damage. So ANEXIS have got that numerical advantage. They think Crows is clear. It actually isn't, but they are going to be able to get on there and get this plant. So Pimp's going to get this bomb down. Bomb's going to be ticking away. Nade's going to go up into Crows. Flashes are going to be going off. This is a crucial part of the round. These frags come in for VERYGAMES. You'll feel they'll be able to steamroller their way in and take it. But Glaive and Nico have stopped that from happening with two excellent kills. Kenny S having to fall back from outside, and I don't think they're going to go for it, VERYGAMES. I think they're just going to save their guns. And in the end, ANEXIS are going to get out of dodge so they don't get taken out by the blast explosion. And a great sound awareness there from Kenny S to take down MSL. And they're just going to drop down this outside stairs area. Kenny S gets another one as well. So
I don't think they should hunt anymore. I mean, it's very easy to get picks with the AWP.
Does actually get Kenny S. So
yeah, but still, I mean,
Well, it is important because they did take an AWP away from them.
Yeah, okay, this time it worked. But if the... he has an AWP anyways. So if you're like... If VERYGAMES in this situation has more money than ANEXIS, I just think they should save their AKs. That would have been my decision, at least.
So ANEXIS trying to get a foothold in the game. It's now 6-2 for VERYGAMES, but ANEXIS back in it. Great little pick again. Kenny S dominating Nico on this map. No doubt about that. It was about a 50-50 split before, but Nico is having a terrible time. Every time he goes outside, Kenny S just seems to be there waiting for him. And Glaive is going to pick up that AWP, and as he turns around, going to get rifled in the back. So VERYGAMES frustrating ANEXIS as they push outside. And ANEXIS now really thinking, well, this round might have gone. And they're just trying to turn around. You can see Pimp just missing someone. And while that happens, Scream's going to wrap around, take down Nilla. It is looking like it's going to be another round to VERYGAMES. MSL got just a little bit of damage, but full complement of nades for him on Razor, and they are going to go back and save. Obviously, they've got the nades as well.
And actually, I don't know, in Source, was it usual to have an AWP as terrorist on this map? Because it was never used in 1.6.
Yeah, actually, what you would do in Source primarily is you would take that AWP and you would use it to get a pick radio room, or you would go and you would directly challenge outside. They would be the two areas of the map you would really challenge in Source. You don't see outside challenges as much on Go. I think that's mainly because of kind of a little bit of different layout on the outside where the box is assembled. You've got a lot more places to hide behind, I think, for the CT. You don't really see that as much anymore. Plus smokes. It's easy to smoke out. The smokes are a lot more effective. But I still think you could use it effectively to pick radio room. I think, again, it's more about the fact that the smokes actually work and they bloom pretty big in Go. Yeah. Whereas in Source, there was all sorts of little bugs and one-way smokes and things that you could do.
Because it's just weird seeing an Optu on this map. I feel like even for VERYGAMES, they should go for... As we talked about earlier, I prefer straight-up rifles on this map.
What you have to remember is, as well, though, the way Nico plays, he will use his AWP like it's a rifle almost. Like, he won't try an AWP from far away. Yeah. He'll just get close and try and rely on his reactions to make close frags. So, for him, it's his weapon of choice. It's what he always plays with. And he can use a rifle, but he's definitely a superior AWPer. But speaking of superior AWPing, Kenny S spamming away outside with a great little reaction shot to take down Glaive, even though he missed the first one. And that's going to give VERYGAMES a numerical advantage. They're going to be 5-4 here, and the Scream's going to get pushed here. It's going to be another headshot. It's what Scream's all about. He just seems to be an absolute headshot machine. So he's going to get a kill. That's 4-3. Kenny S has been taken out by ANEXIS, but They get all the wraparound frags now. VERYGAMES existence probably should have made that kill there.
Yeah, for sure.
Felt a bit weak that he didn't make it, and then he dropped back immediately, which shows again he's conscious of missing those frags. And then all of a sudden, Pimpanilla are going to get to. It's now a 2v2 situation out of nowhere, and with that smoke down on that bombsite area and Pimp in this position, they're going to get this bomb plant. They're actually probably got the upper hand because Nico's one of the people that are alive. He's got an AWP. I'm not too sure of how advantageous their positions are. Kind of hard to tell on the radar. But Pimp's the guy that's gone back, and Nico's the guy on site with the AWP. You would definitely want it to be the other way around. They've thrown a Molotov down. They're trying to burn him out. Pimp with Chris Bane. But all of a sudden, MBK's going to answer back into 1v1. MBK versus Pimp. MBK's going to get it. Has he got time to get on this defuse?
Yeah, he has for sure.
He has got time.
A great play from NBK.
And yeah, absolutely great play to come up clutch in that situation. In the end, there wasn't anything Pimp could do, but it's like I say, what was crucial to that round going the way of VERYGAMES was it was Nico that went in to plant the bomb. He had the AWP, he was stuck on site, and it was Pimp that had to go back to the ramp room. I think if it had been reversed, ANEXIS win that round.
Yeah, for sure, and that they actually had an firebomb like left in that situation.
Yeah.
Kind of weird.
Yeah, well, it definitely played its part.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it proves that it can be useful sometimes.
So ANEXIS now unable to really string together any of the momentum that they would have liked. They're just picking up scraps, and they're on another eco. And looks like they're going to give Scream some movie frags. Make that 1, 2, 3, and then Smiths comes in for the fourth. You are denied. Oh no, it was 2 apiece. I do apologize, but Smith did as he gets the 3-man in the end to make it 9-2. Time to have a quick look at the frag charts. Let's see how they've impacted on the scores. Smith's at the top with 14-6. Pimp 7-8, but ANEXIS really haven't had anyone stand out, and they are struggling on this map at the moment, Bjorn.
Yeah, for sure, but however, it is one of the most CG-sided maps, so mm-hmm. if they manage to get at least 4 or 5 rounds, I would say they're okay, but they really need at least 2 more rounds.
It looks to me almost as if ANEXIS haven't even bothered to put together any kind of specific terrorist strats for this map, because such is the reputation of VERYGAMES on Nuke. I think most people actually do presume that if you're playing VERYGAMES on Nuke, you've already lost. And that you've got to give them that map and beat them on the other two.
Yeah, let's see here. They actually managed to get out from Kenny S in a weird position, managed to get one frag, dies to Nila, but still nice from him to manage to get at least one there.
Yeah, and actually, as I'm saying that, you know, ANEXIS have managed to give themselves a numerical advantage, not necessarily through good strats, but VERYGAMES seem to push out a little bit aggressively. Nico's going to get that AWP kill, so he's managed to try and get his groove back. It's going to be a 4v2 situation. Existence can't push through that fire, and was just having a spray away before MSL gets him. And just as Smiths drops down, Smiths having been the danger man for VERYGAMES, Nico's waiting for him with an AWP. It makes it 9-3. Still a big, big advantage for VERYGAMES, though.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, ANEXIS will be forced to eco if they lose this round. And it won't be an eco since it's only three rounds left, so I was wrong. Yeah, but still, counted wrong there. But yeah, for sure, they have a lot of pressure on them, and they really need to rack up at least one more round this half.
I definitely agree with you. 3 rounds is not going to be enough. It puts massive pressure on the pistol round. Smith's going aggressive, coming through the radio room, so he's going to be pushing. But all that happens, MSL's just managed to get out of main. Didn't seem to be covered there from VERYGAMES, so that's bad communications from them. But in the end, MSL does get shut down. But what information is he going to be able to relay? Glaive spamming away through the smoke. You can see Existence is playing in that MBK spot, if you like, actually on the bomb site, and definitely not having the same level of efficiency and not able to spray anyone down to death through the hook, but certainly did some damage. But damage has been done to VERYGAMES as well. Existence on half HP, Scream on 29 HP. So this round pretty much even Stevens, even though VERYGAMES do have that numerical advantage. It is a 4-on-3, but ANEXIS can turn that round in a heartbeat with 2 quick kills. So they're not committing. They're waiting for VERYGAMES to push. They're going to be bitterly disappointed, I'd say, or maybe not. Who's this? Having a little sneaky peek through radio room. You can see Kenny S as well, just lining up. And then, he seemed to take damage or something. I'm not quite sure what sort of bug that was. It went just suspiciously red for a moment. But ANEXIS are kind of boxed in lobby at the moment, and they're relying on Glaive to kind of released them and freed them. And that flash worked brilliantly. Nico in the end got the kill. Glaive got killed by Smith. Screen's going to answer back and then Smith's going to shut him down. Smith's having a great game at the moment. It's 10 rounds to 3. There's 2 rounds left. If ANEXIS don't win these 2 rounds, is it pretty much over?
Yeah, I would say so. I don't even think the pistol round will matter that much. I like to play from VERYGAMES. They're going really aggressive on ramp. I've seen this a lot from VERYGAMES. If they string a lot of rounds together and get confident, then they lose a round. Then they just counter the next round with just completely just rushing the other team, which they did there.
Well, it's interesting that you pointed out because and that's what ANEXIS were doing to VERYGAMES on Inferno. But again, it's these are clearly this is the battle of the veto because what we've seen is ANEXIS on their map beat VERYGAMES. We've seen VERYGAMES just totally at home on Nuke, really dominating at the moment, and ANEXIS almost kind of surrendering it a little bit. I'm confident it's going to go to a third map, and I'm confident it's going to be all about that map. So we'll try and find out what that is in advance. But game's still not over yet. You can see we had a kill from Glaive there on NBK. Always a good person to get out of the game early if you can. Is a danger man, but ANEXIS, you can see they're a little bit antsy, a little bit afraid. They're not wanting to push in.
They really need to utilize their flashes good right now.
Well, the flashes are going off, and we're as blind as the players are, but who's going to get their eyesight back first? Glaive and Nilla get 2 kills. Pim's going to answer back. This is a textbook upper push, and you can see that the last man standing, Scream, lurking down there like it's like being the hunter from Left 4 Dead. You can see where he is. He's going to come up through the vents just as the bomb is planted. Can he get a kill here? Well, no, he's going to get wrapped around behind. MSL's surely going to get the kill, and does, and that's going to be a round to make it 10-4 to ANEXIS. They need to win this last round, in my opinion, to have any chance. We'll stay with the commentary and just see how they're going to do it. And it's a full buy as well, so Nico is going to have to use that AWP and use it well. So let's see where they're going.
I actually think if they manage to win this round and win the pistol, they're actually in an advantageous position. So this is a really important round, I would say.
Well, yeah, and definitely it's going to be a factor. The pistol round is going to be hugely important in the swingometer of where this game's going, but VERYGAMES is going aggressive. You can see Scream, and I think it is Smiths as well, just going to be pushing through that radio room. Scream's going to get a couple of kills, headshots through walls, it seems like there's not a problem for Scream. So he's got 2 kills, pretty much shut down this round before it begins. ANEXIS is going to be able to make the pendulum swing back in their favour. Probably not. Nico, very low HP, not that ever matters when you're an AWPer, and there's 2 great kills from Glaive. So the pendulum evenly balanced at the moment. Now MSL's going to answer back. He's on the ladder though, not able to get another kill, but it hardly took any damage whatsoever. Did a little bit to existence, and ANEXIS are able to drop lower. This is a fantastic round from them. It looked all but over. They're now in a 3v2 situation. And they're spamming away into the vents. Oh no, that's a bit of a fail from MSL. Went aggressive. Now he's left a lot to do for his teammates, but they still need to get out of this vent. You can see that Nico again in that position, having to play close. Glaive needs to hold his nerve and make this kill. He does. It's now a 1v2 situation. Kenny S on low HP. Nico just looking around. He does get that kill. It is going to be 10-5. Brilliant round from ANEXIS. Can they kick on and do more to VERYGAMES to win this map?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, if they take the pistol round is very, very important. I think the team that wins the pistol round has maybe an 80% chance of winning the game. So I know both teams know it, and they're. Let's see if they can show some interesting pistol rounds now, because I feel like, as in 1.6, the CT is very favored on the pistol round on this map.
Definitely. It's hard to imagine VERYGAMES losing Nuke, and especially with, you know, a 10-5 lead. But again, the pistol's so crucial, and we talk about how it sets you up financially, we talk about how many rounds it gives you. We've already seen a couple of ecos, so I don't even know if you can take that for granted at this moment in time. But it's the psychological factor. Every time, you know, VERYGAMES are a map behind. You cannot underestimate what that does to the mindset while you're playing. And if this pistol round does indeed go the way of ANEXIS, will VERYGAMES maybe be starting to panic a little bit? We know how emotional they can be. We saw it in day one.
Yeah, for sure. And just as you say that, they are starting the pistol round.
All right, so let's see what we've got going on. We're going to quickly jump on the overlay because we want to see if anyone's going to do what they call wolf packing it, where they all just run in one direction and use the weight of numbers. But MBK seems to be leading the charge outside. So
look at the
face full of nade. there. That HE grenade did absolute tons of damage. And even though Scream got the kill, this is it's going to have a huge, huge impact on the round. You can see Smith so low, existence down to half HP. So Nico with a great nade there in the end. He just threw it right at their feet. And you can see he said, nice shot afterwards. They should be complimenting him on a nice nade. So our Verygames going to be able to capitalize. And that's a great little crab claw there on Ramp. They've hit them from both directions to get the kill. It's a 4-on-3 situation. But again, remember, we've got some very, very low HP Verygames players. They are going to take all over this lower bomb site and make it their very own. They're going to be able to get ninjaed up into all the positions. And Smith, it is, gets taken down. But Kenny S is going to answer back immediately. So it's a 3v2 situation in favor of Verygames. Next kill, absolutely vital. Of course, MSL and Pimp do have full HP. Great little reaction headshot on MBK. So existence and Kenny S taking flak from all directions, and MSL and Pimp on full HP. Are they going to be able to do it? Are they going to be able to rotate? These bombs ticking away. They're going to have to go. They're going to have to get the skates on. They are going to do it. It's now a 2v1 situation. They've got to get the defuse, though. Pimp is the low HP one. He's going to go, oh, that nade was an absolute... Oh, actually, it turns out to be smart play. They used the nade to blow the door open, but they haven't got a kit. 7 seconds. Are they going to be able to get this defuse?
Yeah, he will get the defuse. No worries. Quite tough, though.
Well, right. I've got to ask you a question. You're a player. Yeah. It looked like they'd messed up opening the door and throwing the nade into it, but were they actually just throwing the nade down to make the door blow up so they could shoot through it?
I actually don't know, but both situations would have worked, so I actually think they just tried to blow it up, it looked like, because he won, like, backed away before he threw it.
Well, we'll definitely give him the benefit of the doubt, and there you go. That was a great bit of smart play, intelligent play, to give him the pistol round. So it looks like we are indeed going to see them go to 10-8, but we've already seen a couple of ecos, so don't take your eyes off this game, not by any means.
And I just want to talk about, like, buying grenades as tea on pistol rounds. Like, it seems like it's very common right now.
Yeah.
But it's a big risk because you don't have any armor versus the grenades, as you saw in the last round.
Mm.
So, like, in all years through CES, the metagame, like, changes. T buys grenades, then CT buys HE. And then they start to buy armor, which makes grenade bad again, which makes them stop by. You can see the pattern
there. Yeah, totally.
So it's like, it's interesting metagame thing that people might not know about.
Well, so far so good. We're at 10-7. And just having a look to see what kind of...
They're throwing a lot of decoys on yard. This is a very interesting tactic. These threw, I think it was 4 decoys on yard.
So we've not really seen any successful decoy strats executed, but
they should really push if they're using their decoys.
Well, yeah, exactly. You would think that the point of it is to go fast. So in the end, it looks like First Blood's going to go to Kenny S in that 1v1 duel, but the whole element of the decoys in that strat hasn't really come into play. It just seemed to be a waste of money, although they've got flashes coming in on upper. And at the moment, Verygames are just absolutely decimating ANEXIS. Scream with another great headshot. Kenny S with a great round there. And they just took upper like it was so easy.
You know what I think they was trying to do? I think they might have watched ANEXIS demos, and they threw decoys on the T roof, faking that there were like 3 guys up there spamming the roof, knowing that ANEXIS trying to push lobby then.
Right.
And then there were 4 guys in lobby, defending lobby. So they were actually trying to fake a T-spamming roof.
Yeah, I see. Yeah. Well, that is smart play, and it's interesting. We've seen lots of little intelligent bits of play, but so far, that Verygames have managed to kind of just bounce back there with a brilliantly executed buy round. I mean, you can say beyond, perhaps a lot more intelligent than we're giving it credit for. You can just see this eco round going pretty much the same way as the last round did, which of course was a buy round. ANEXIS is getting chopped down. Nico, the last man standing, 1v4 clutch with a pistol, not likely to happen. And Verygames looking to consolidate this lead on their map, on the map that we all know they're so very good on. But ANEXIS have shown some nice flourishes, but at the moment they're getting really, they're just getting dominated as CT.
Yeah, I mean, it's still only been like 1 weapon round, so it's hard to say yet, but it's not looking good for ANEXIS. They're really low on money, and they can buy this round, but we see Nilla with the farmers, so if they don't win this round, I think Verygames will take this map.
Well, it's certainly, everything's there that you would want if you were a team. You've got the lead, you've got the money advantage, it's your map. And Verygames will be feeling confident about this. But of course, ANEXIS, not shy on confidence. They like to book trends, and they certainly feel better about things when the odds are stacked against them. Very much thrive on the them and us mentality. VERYGAMES at the moment, just kind of looking, they're getting ready for a big push on upper, and it worked so well last time. Why the hell not? MSL's going to try and do the counter flashes, and Pimp's going to get our first kill. MSL's kind of, well, he doesn't even know what's going on. Looks like he flashed himself there more than anything. Smith is going to get a cheeky double on upper, and you can see Glaive's just going to try and drop some flashes, drop some smokes down there, trying to prevent the plant. Scream's just waiting for the rotate. Kenny's going to get a kill. Smith is going to get another one. And they are looking incredibly weak on upper at the moment, ANEXIS. VERYGAMES can just walk in there like it's their house. And Nico, again, the last man standing from his position based on kind of outside in Crow's area. And probably just going to save that gun and wait for people to come out of main so we can maybe pick one or two of them off.
Yeah, and what I think ANEXIS should do now is, of course, do an eco next round. And then they should try to be aggressive lobby, maybe be aggressive yard, maybe. They can't let VERYGAMES do their upper execution because it's just too good for them to defend. Yeah. So they have to take the fight to the T's.
Well, what I'd like to see is it's a strat that used to get used all the time in Source to split things up, and that would be where you would take pretty much all of the CT team, maybe bar one on upper, so you could call if they got in there, and you would push everyone on the outside and then try and wrap around and catch them from behind in lobby. And you don't really see that in Go. No one seems to go mega aggressive outside of CT anymore.
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, you don't have to like push around either. You can like push three guys. Okay, there's nobody here. Then go back and push ramp maybe. Like, be active. It doesn't really pay off to be passive versus a team that has good execution.
Well, it's going to be a pistol round, and we're on 13-7 in favor of VERYGAMES, so they are getting closer to that victory that they need to stay in this game. Let's not forget, if you just join us, ANEXIS did win that first map. They beat them 16-12, I believe it was, on Inferno. So, incredible play from the Danes, but a very different story here on Nuke. And this eco round should play in with the rest of that story. It should fit in nicely as its very own unique chapter of VERYGAMES dominance. But we have seen some ecos as well. So Nilla with a great little flash, and the planets were aligning, but he still only managed to get one kill, but he did a lot of damage. That might be a factor. MSL not able to get his aim. That flash really threw him off. It could have been two easy kills for him, but it's a 3v4 situation. But Scream and Smith both incredibly low for VERYGAMES. Existence is going to get a kill, and the distance just really not working out there. Oh, but it's a team kill. It's the comedy VERYGAMES team kill that we've seen a few times. Kenny S is going to take down Smith after a terrible nade, but he is going to avenge it of sorts by taking out the ANEXIS player as well. It's a 1v3 situation. Pimp on full HP. All of the VERYGAMES players bruised and battered, but without a gun, Pimp really can't be expected to clutch this. He's certainly going to have a go. No point in letting the bomb go off, as we've established with the money situation, but it's hard to even get a peek going on in vents. And in the end, what's he going to do? He's just going to back off. He's going to try and find a weapon maybe, but certainly he's going to let the bomb go off. That's going to give VERYGAMES a lot more money, but it's also going to get them one round closer to being at match point. And we'll have a quick look at the frag charts just at this juncture as well. But right now VERYGAMES are in absolute complete control, and you can see that Glaive is at the top 16 for 16. Also had a great first game. Smith 23 for 12, been brilliant, and he's the unsung hero a lot of times for VERYGAMES. But at 14-7 now, VERYGAMES is surely going to close this out.
I think so for sure. The only way ANEXIS can get back in this is that, like, they win three flawless rounds in a row or something, stringing many rounds together. And the way they've been playing so far, I don't think that is going to happen.
That's interesting as well. We talked about how good VERYGAMES are on it, and how we said at the start they have a very strong T half, and they just have absolutely played their T strats to near perfection. And ANEXIS have felt the need to go double AWP setup here on Nuke. Nico and Glaive both doing it. Now, can Nilla do something here? He's going to get one, going to get two as he's pushed in the ramp room. And this is looking a lot better. VERYGAMES have played this tactic a little bit loose. It's now 5-on-3 in favor of the Danes. And they're still having this duel. Kenny has getting a face full of flashing, just kind of spamming at the wall there. Nico playing this tight little angle. Wow.
That was a quick catch-up.
That was a ridiculous insta-aim. I bet Nico's going to be thinking, what the hell just happened there? Incredible shot from MBK. Don't think it's going to have much of an impact on the round. But Nico's up, down, like just out-rifled. K Kenny's going to get another kill here. So all of a sudden, it's a 2v3 situation. And ANEXIS just kind of wilting in the spotlight, really throwing this round at the moment. And
yeah, I think they're going to win it anyways. They think someone is up the ladder, so they're like, it's a bit too much boosting. But they can't know that no one's there. So
yeah, well, there we go. We've got 20 seconds, 15 now left on the clock. And well, it's still a kill from MBK, so he's dropping down. But in the end, ANEXIS do hold their nerve, makes it 14-8. And I guess, I mean, at this stage, right, when it looks like you're going to lose a game and you've got pretty much, you know, you've got to win 8 rounds in a row to win the game, to be guaranteed to win it. What's going through your mind as a player? I mean, when you're in this situation, you've already got one map. Do you just think, let's end this one quickly so we can play our map, play the third map and dominate? Or do you think the longer we push them, the harder we push them, the easier it is for us?
Well, when you're in such a big deficit, we at least always try to take one round at a time. We always try to win the map, of course, so like take one round at a time. It's not impossible, I see it on Nuke as well, so if they don't get stressed out, it's not impossible.
Well, with aiming like that, it's going to prove very difficult, if not impossible. MBK just chops down Glaive. And you can see that Kenny S was indeed the first one to fall in the round, but it's a 4v4 situation. And not great weapons either for ANEXIS. You can still see that they've got Famuses as well. So
yeah,
playing it slow.
I think VERYGAMES has an advantage this round. I mean, they already have the lower area, so ANEXIS basically have more places to defend than they have players.
Yeah, and they're going to get the bomb plant down in the slower area. You can see that Existence being spammed through the smoke. Existence being relegated to the position of official bomb planter extraordinaire. And ANEXIS unable to stop it, but we're going to get some interesting duels coming in. And this is a big round. Nilla took a lot of damage there from MBK, so he lost that initial exchange, but didn't die. And of course, the farmer's not great for those close quarter battles, certainly not compared to the AK. Smith and Existence going to get a kill, but are going to get pegged back. Nilla and Nico are going to answer back to make it a 2v2, but the bomb's taken away while that's happening. Existence is going to take out the very low HP, and there it is. The bomb is going to go off, and we're going to be at match point for VERYGAMES. Nico's going to survive, but I don't think it's going to make a lot of difference in the end. Yeah, not even an exit frag, so to speak. So it's 15-8. I think we're going to see this go 16-8 in favor of VERYGAMES, and therefore we will see a third map.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, VERYGAMES is low on money. They might be able to string rounds together, like if they try something completely different, but I think they might actually already have given up on this map.
Yeah, I think mentally they're like, you know, this is the map we expected to lose. They knew that if they were going to win, it was going to be 2-1. They didn't expect to get through flawlessly. You know that VERYGAMES, if they get to play you on you, you know what they're going to do to you. And ANEXIS know that they're capable of beating VERYGAMES. They just proved it. They took the first map. So it all depends on the final map and what strats they got lined up. But ANEXIS is going to get the first kill with that. AK Smith is going to answer back immediately and take down Nilla. So VERYGAMES is going to push into this ramp area, and of course controlling that is so important within the context of the game, because you can push upper and lower from it and stop rotates. It's the heart of the map, if you like. And ANEXIS at the moment in this 4-on-4 with inferior weapons. It's a bit of a hodgepodge. We see all sorts of farm machinery being used. But in the end, Glaive's going to get a kill. He was expecting more to be there. Smith, who's had a great game, going to be keen to push. Look at that for a headshot. Just perfect onto Glaive to make it a 3v3 situation. But Smith did get some shrapnel as a result. And you can see that MSL is trying to spam away with that pistol from distance. Going to drop them even lower. So Kenny S and Smith hardly is in the game at all. It's not a formality that this game is over yet by any means. So if they had given up, you wouldn't know it from the way they're playing, but Scream's going to insta-Nico again. Pimp is going to get a kill, but it's a 2v2 situation. Look how low Kenny S is. So it's all important here. Pimp's going to get the kill on Kenny S, who was outside. The headshot total overkill, completely unnecessary for him. It's a 2v1 situation. It's all about how they plant it, how they play it, sorry, while the bomb is planted. And oh, he's gone at the spray, but in the end, Pimp's going to be able to adjust his recoil accordingly to take this round. So we're going to have one more round here.
Yeah, and don't really think it changed much now, but maybe we are on our way in a fantastic comeback. Who knows? The bomb has been defused.
Well, we've already seen some ridiculous comebacks. VERYGAMES have been involved in them. ANEXIS have certainly been involved in a few of their own.
Yeah, and as I said, for ANEXIS to turn this around, they need to do something different. I mean, their standard CT rounds hasn't worked. Maybe they should try to just maybe switch positions, play more mix-like or something, because what they're doing is not working versus VERYGAMES.
Well, a little bit of a lag spike there, but no problems. We're still with the game, and Kenny S gets the first kill. You can see that Pimp is on this upper site, just kind of waiting. And MSL is out of the equation. Smith is as well. So again, 4v4. These rounds deceptively close at this stage of the game, but they just always seem to be that flurry of frags that go to VERYGAMES. Pimp, great little headshot from him. MBK removed from the equation. So ANEXIS in a favorable position here. They've got what looks to be a lockdown on upper. VERYGAMES taking that bomb, probably going lower with it. You can see that Nilla is just poised there on ramp, just having a look around, got a lot of space to cover, and they've gone the long way to take it lower, so they're going to bypass Nilla.
And this is going to be really hard for VERYGAMES. It's so hard when you get down that area, you can be shot from both the vents and the ramp area.
Well, they've sent somebody lobby to try and fake out the plant, but it looks like we've had a call and there's a rotate going on. You can see there's been a little bit of an exchange damage-wise, and Scream in the end is going to get a kill, and then Kenny S and Scream gets a double from nowhere, double headshot. Kenny S is going to get one. All of a sudden, it's all on Nico. Absolutely no way you felt ANEXIS could have lost this round, but it looks like that's what's going to happen, barring some magic from Nico. Going to walk straight into a VERYGAMES crossfire, going to get taken down. GG, it is the third map, 16-9 to VERYGAMES on Nuke. So pretty much as we expected, our analysis team.